Hello everyone, my name is Avigna Venkatesh. I am from Aund in Pune, Maharashtra. Today I will show you how to apply the reverse function in Python, and I am studying Python courses in Diya Academy. So come on, I'll show you how to apply the reverse function in Python. So first type def. What is def? Def is called define. It is the short form. And reverse. Reverse is the function. And in bracket, write the variable that you are going to use. So what does this line of code mean? Def is define. Reverse is the function. And s is any variable. Later I will take s as the name of the variable and write the string. So that's why I'm taking s. Or you can take any letter also. It's okay. Now type an empty string. Why? Because the reversed string, the reversed code or the empty code, something should come in the empty string. There should be an empty string. So that's why I'm typing an empty string. Now next type for I in S. This means I is any variable. S is the variable that we will take in the start. So for I in S, so I will be the variable which will get reversed later. Okay, so that's why I'm putting for I in S. Here type string is equal to I plus string. So this actually means the string is the final string, okay, which will come as the reversed one, and I is only the reversed part, and string which is the original string, original sentence which we will write, not the reversed one. So when we add the original and the reversed one together, then only we will get the final string. So that's why it's string is equal to I plus string. Now go to next, go to backspace, it should be in the line of code of for, and type return string here. Why? Because if we don't put return string, then what will come in the output section? No, it has to get executed and we have to see the result. So return the string, the final string. Okay, now let's start the actual code where I'm taking an actual variable and showing you. So this we have defined what is reverse. Now we'll start S. Why am I taking S? Because in the start also I have taken it S. So we should not keep on changing it. Because or else then it will say not defined. So now S, I am taking my name is Avigna. Okay, this is a string. Now here, now I've taken the string. Now print what we have to print? The original sentence is. Why am I doing this? Because we should know which is the original sentence and which is the reverse sentence. So here at the start of the sentence it will say original, this is the original sentence, and this is the empty string which you have taken in the start in line 2. Then in the empty string, the string which will come, my name is Avigna. Okay, so now print s. Why? In that empty string something should be written. Na. So my name is Avigna, Avigna will come in that. And now print the reversed string is. Why? Because we should know which is the reverse string, comma, because after this end will come. And empty string. Why empty string? In that empty string only the reversed code will come. Now after this if I leave it like this and run the code, it will say the original sentence is my name is Avigna and the reverse string is also my name is Avigna. That is wrong, right? So here instead of string I can put sentence, although both are correct, but I just want to maintain a uniformity. And so now after this we have to type one more thing, which is the final. So what does this do? The reverse string is end here in the open string, it will, in the empty string it will type the reverse of S. So what is S? My name is Avigna. And reverse of S is the reverse of that sentence. So let's run this and see. So you can see here the original sentence is my name is Avigna and the reverse sentence is it's coming reversed. Each and every word is reversed. So this is how we can apply the reversed string, the reversed function for any string. Thank you.